Hello, good evening, and welcome to Destiny Scroll Time with Emperor Emmanuel Melchizedek, Voice of Everlasting Solution. With Jesus' joy, I welcome you to this awesome service. The month of self-seeking and focus, and by the grace of God, I'll be running the second series on face self-seeking. So I welcome you, all that are joining us online, and those that will be here present. You are all welcome. It's an awesome time to be in God's presence, and I feel excited in my spirit to be bringing across an awesome revelation and secret. That is the number one obligation of every living man. And before we go into the message proper, we'll take word of prayer. Then I will introduce the message. Faithful Father, we bring worship. We worship you here. That gave birth to himself. You are the true origin of all things. You are the Father of light. You dwell in a brightness that can never be approached. You depended on the mystery of your personality and brightness to solve the confused state of the very beginning. And by election of grace, you brought me as your human representative, to share the last ideology that you would depend on to give birth to the last people. And I ask, let your people receive support from the capital spirit that owns this season. Let your people gain understanding. Let thy living light saturate the darkness of our soul. And by the testimony of thy living light, we'll receive new help to discover who we are in you. Thank you, faithful Father, for hearing our prayers. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. I'm going to be running. Today is an awesome service. And I'll be sharing something that is very, very important, and that's the number one work for every living man. So the sacredness of what I'm about sharing, keep me inside for a good number of hours now, and I know I will be saying it, and the reason why I'm bringing it is to help us to understand, because God told me that this month is a month of self-seeking and focus, and there's something about focus. Distraction is one of the greatest harm. The greatest harm that any living man can have is to be distracted. And one of the key things that cause men to be distracted in life is lack of vision, is lack of purpose. So this message I dedicate it to all that have understanding to use their mind. So I welcome you by the grace of God. I'll be sharing the second series of self-seeking. So today I'll be discussing on seeking yourself from the light of yourself, by yourself and from yourself. Seeking yourself from the light of yourself, by yourself and from yourself. Now I want to make the first point. And the first point is that you can't look for yourself in blindness. You can't look for yourself in darkness. Now, when you hear the word seeking is synonymous to looking. The word seeking is synonymous to looking, and also synonymous to meditation. Let me say again, when I'm talking about seeking, I'm talking about looking, and I'm also talking about meditation. Now, this is the first job, the first capital job of every living man that wants to matter in this millennium, that don't want to lose relevance. The first job to do is to look for yourself. And I also want to make this point that every man is a mystery. Let me say again, every man on earth is a mystery. Now, you are a mystery because you are wired in a complicated way. And hear me, in case you believe in going after prophecies and then to go and make inquiries from those that are soothsayers and call themselves prophets, you'll be very disappointed, because who you are the first prophet that you should know about yourself before any other thing that any person will be telling you is a confirmation of what you have already known. Now, I want you to have the understanding that you are your own prophet. And hear me, whatsoever you cannot discover by yourself and from yourself, if another person, if you are depending on the external body to know yourself, then you can't know yourself enough. You can never depend on prophecy that is coming from a second person to know yourself. Because every man, like I said, you are a mystery. And when God created you, God hide you inside yourself. And hear me, you cannot be known more than the way you know yourself. And the impact you will make in life and how much people can celebrate you or honor you or adore you is tied to what you make out of yourself. So I found it very expensive sharing what I'm about sharing. What I'm sharing is why Adam was recognized as the first man. And of course, I'll be reading all that I'll be doing in this teaching, in this month of self-seeking, is from the book of beginning. Life begins in confusion. I want to say this as a gift. One of the gifts and one of the things that I know as voice of everlasting solution. Life begins in confusion and life will end in confusion. And that's why in this last millennium that we are in, we are already in a state of confusion. These men are already confused because there are a lot of things that are going on that they can't place their hand on. So there is confusion everywhere. And hear me, in the midst of the confusion that is on earth, that confusion, that thing that some are calling confusion, is housing the greatness of people like Emperor Emmanuel Melchizedek, of people like the participants of this meeting, people that are part of the world of unique relevance. The confusion that is on is housing our greatness, our worthiness. So the first thing to seek, to look for in life, is not money. Now, anytime a man abandons himself and then starts looking for money, he will end in frustration. Because the more you look for money without discovering who you are, the more money will be running away from you. So money is not meant to be pursued. What you are meant to look for is yourself. Because when you find yourself, then every other thing will be in place. Just like what the scripture said. When the scripture said in the book of Matthew 6:33 says, seek ye first. Now there is always first thing to seek for. Say, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and every other thing shall be added. And I'm here rephrasing it to say to you, seek first yourself. Seek first yourself, and every other thing you need in life will come to you when you have found yourself. So if you want to matter in this millennium, this teaching I'm running this month, of course, is one of my sacred seasons. Yeah, 2021 happens to be one of the sacred years that I ever know. From what God is telling me, from what God is revealing to me, I'm more than conscious of 2021. And looking at the events of life as they keep unfolding in 2021, I know there is more to year 2021, more than people are beholding it to be. There is something about the year 2021. And that's why when God came to me and said to me that July is a month of self-seeking, that I should bring this consciousness to people. And of course, if you hear me talking about self-seeking, yeah, I'm talking about self-seeking because there are things I've known about myself, and I also know that there are things I've not yet known. And I'm making effort to know it. I know myself. Last week when I was teaching, of course, that teaching was, I didn't document it. And even this one that I'm documenting, before I made up my mind that I'm going to document, it took me time. And I'm teaching without, the thing I'm teaching is coming direct. I didn't write down. And I know the power of what each time I'm coming this way, I know the power behind it. I am teaching direct from looking inside. I'm beholding. And I'm giving out what I'm seeing. I have been beholding since morning before coming out. My coming out, this day, the time that men are setting their eyes on me, just now that I'm coming out. Since the daybreak. And it's a consciousness. It's a consciousness that I know that there is something about this time. And they hear me, and like I said, this it's just my coming out. And distraction has been coming from here and there. A lot of calls, missed calls I ignored. A lot of things that is trying to come and take away my attention. And I ignore it. And even as I arrive, then distraction also came. And now hear me, in the path of destiny, there are distractions everywhere. And let me say this. One of the things that will prove your divinity is your ability to maintain focus in the midst of distraction. Because we are living in a time that is full of distraction. And the distraction happens to be one of the strongest tools of the enemy of man. Distraction happens to be the greatest enemy of destiny of man. So if you can conquer distraction, then you're already on your way to greatness. If you have ability to know the things that you're not supposed to give attention to at a particular time, you're already on your way to greatness. One of the ways to interpret greatness is in what I'm teaching you now. Your ability to know things that doesn't matter to you. Yeah, there are things that may matter to some people in a particular time. But hear me, one of the ways to know your peculiarity and your uniqueness is in separating yourself from what you treasure. That's separating yourself from your thought, knowing what matters, what to give attention to at a particular time in life, and what not to give attention to. And it's only men that have understanding of greatness that can live such a life. I want to celebrate my spiritual father because all along, yeah, I want to bless him. Meeting him is a blessing, Reverend Chris Christian. Peace to him. Meeting him gave me boldness. Meeting him authenticated what I know about myself. And he gave me boldness. to tread in the path of spirit without fear. So I have consciousness. I have consciousness. So there are things I've known about myself and I'm still making efforts because there are things I've not yet known. And I know I will know it because I'm already on the path that is leading me to them. And I'm not just saying it. I'm saying it from encounter. I'm saying it from knowledge. I want to celebrate him. Before coming out, I was fellowshipping with him. Yeah, fellowshipping with him in a book. So he says something that you know, a lot of things, but I just want to bring out something. Many, many years ago, there are things that when I'm reading his book, and I keep seeing them, it authenticates what I've been told. So he said that knowledge is stronger than prophecy. And there's another thing he said that I want to bring out. He said that in life there are three things to learn. There are three things to learn. Number one, you learn to know. And also you relearn what you know. And also you unlearn what you have learned. Now, it's not something. You learn to know and you relearn what you know and you unlearn what you have learned. It's a gift. I will not interpret it. Maybe in subsequent teaching I will interpret it. But I'm saying it the way he said it. And I understood it by understanding who I am from being. So the number one job to do in life is to look for yourself. Man is a treasure. It's a hidden treasure. And when once a man have ability to discover himself, every other treasure will come to him. In the place of waiting, I begin to look. And I have understanding that, you know, I study economics. One of the things about money, they use money to measure value. And a lot of people that are looking for money don't have understanding that money measures value. Now, I want to give you this as a gift. That if money measures value, money can never go to valueless men. And if you are valueless, you can never be rich. And you can never get money, no matter the effort you think you are making to have money. Because the more you try to look for money, the more money will run away from you. So what I'm teaching is one of the ways to become rich, one of the ways to become wealthy. I'm teaching this because I know the mandate of the word of unique relevance. And I'm teaching because I have consciousness of what 2021 is all about. I know it that this ministry can't remain the way it is. I'm not saying it by saying sake. I'm saying it from encounter of what has already happened and what is happening around us as a people. So if money measures value, Voice of Everlasting Solution is telling you. So if you will listen to me, that what you need to do is to harvest the value that made you who you are. If you can be able to harvest the value that made you who you are, then you won't look for money. Money will come to you. By the grace of God, there is a series I will go into. There are things I will be teaching maybe next month. Yeah, from knowing. Because there are things I know that remain a secret between me and the spirit that reveal it. Which I can only teach when he asks me to. And if he asks me not to do it, I will never teach it. So I'm teaching this very one now that I'm teaching because I was asked to. If I wasn't asked to, I wouldn't have. Because it's a secret. It's a secret gift. The what of a man is in what he know. And the what and the weight of spirit is in what the spirit know. Now, spirit cannot share what is important to them to ordinary fickle men. Now, because One of the way to, and that's one thing that spirit can't take. If a spirit is shared a revelation that is very, very precious to them, and you're truthful with it, it means the spirit believes that you have insulted him, and is the greatest offense. One of the greatest offense that any man can commit is to snub a revelation that is carrying his life. And what I'm saying is what takes men down below 6 feet. Because they lack ability to know that there are things that you are meant not to trifle with. Because every life is connected to a light. And when you hear that life is connected to a light, according to the book of John, yeah, John, St. John chapter 1, verse 5. Every life is born out of light. And if you are not connected to the life that bear your life, there is no way you will live. So one of the way to die, and that's why people keep dying, is to ignore yourself and then start looking for things. Start looking for material things. And that's what has destroyed a lot of men and a lot of young men. We are in a millennium when God wants to finish his work. God wants to crown what he has started in the beginning of beginnings. And it's a privilege of my life to know that I'm a capital ambassador of that assignment. And that's why the ministry is known as the World of Unique Relevance. So our relevancy is not in grammar. Our relevancy is in the secret that is with us. It's in the secret that we know that we are the only one that God will depend on to communicate it as far as this millennium is concerned. And it's a privilege of our life. So I will read the scripture just to authenticate Genesis 2 verse 5, and then I will read the book of John chapter 3 verse 8. Just two scripture, and then I will round up the message. 1:5. He said, and every plant of the field before they were in the earth, and every herb of the field before it grew. For the Lord God had not caused it to rain upon the earth, and there was not a man to till the ground. Genesis 2:5. There was not a man to till the ground. Now, let me help you to think further. Because last week when I was teaching, these are the scriptures I stood on to teach what I taught. Now, if you go to Genesis 1:26, you will see the scripture saying, let us make man in our own image after our likeness. And let them have dominion over the fishes of the sea and over the fowls of the air and over the cattle and over all the earth and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. Now, and I want to ask a question. In Genesis 1, there was creation. And in 2:5, the scripture says that there was no man. And because there was no man on earth, then God refused to give rain to the earth. Because God knows the essence of the rain. That the essence of giving rain to the earth is for the earth to be tilled. Now, this is a mystery. And it's a mystery where I'm standing on to bring a consciousness that you are meant to look for yourself. You are meant to seek yourself. Now, if you go down, then you begin to say that, you see, verses said, and the air went up a mist from the earth and watered the whole face of the ground. And the Lord God, this verse 7 now, formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. Now, I've said over time that man is not dust. And from what I'm teaching, I'm still emphasizing on it, that man is not dust. All that live in the realm of those are those that are lost in themselves. Now, when you hear this, this formation, what Moses was just bringing to us, like I said in the last teaching that I taught on that breath is, breathing is not living. Yeah, you can go back and watch the message. Yeah, it has phase one and phase two. Breathing is not living. I said that Moses used a coded language. And of course, peace to him. Yeah, because that's how all men that came in his order will teach. Just like what I'm teaching now. What I'm teaching with a coded language, and I'm also encoding some languages. What you are hearing me teaching. You can only understand me by understanding yourself. So I know that man is not dust because I know myself. And I know that I'm not made of dust. And that's why I know that I can't die. I know that I can't go to grave. I know that I can never sleep 6 feet anytime. And why I'm teaching this is to bring you to that realm and platform, because that's the greatest thing that can happen to any living man. People are busy talking about resurrection, talking about eternal life. Now, hear me. We have journeyed beyond the season of resurrection and eternal life. And that's why voice of everlasting solution is sounding. That's why the voice that is sounding now is sounding. That's why Chris Christian has already stand there as a covenant father to champion the mandate and the covenant. Immortality is not a gift. And that's why a lot of people can't attend the realm of immortality. Because it's never a gift. Immortality can only go to a man from what I'm teaching, from self-seeking. Just like if you don't find yourself, you'll be lost inside yourself. And when you're lost inside yourself, you're lost in grave. I don't know how to explain it so that to make you to understand. All that are in grave, they meant there because they lack ability to find themselves. Because all that we find themselves, we never go there. The land of the dead is a land where men that lack ability to know all that they should know about themselves meant to. And even from there, they are still looking back because they know that the journey didn't end in going there. That's why they are still looking towards the earth, because they know that the journey continues. Now, a lot of people think that death is the end. Death is not the end of anything. So don't be even deceived that when you die, that ends it. So, and that's why the greatest effort you need to make in life is to know what you are born to know, to seek yourself. Because I know I'm not teaching for this time only, and that's why I'm documenting it. If you can be able to start paying attention to yourself, to depend on the light that is coming to you to run, then there are some things, some pain that you will never go through in life. I don't know what you've been hearing and what your pastor has been telling you, but I'm voice of everlasting solution. And if I'm voice of everlasting solution, I know what works and I know what does not work. I understood swindling. I understood gainsaying. I know many people are deceived in the name of preaching. So it's a privilege for a man to know that he's hidden in himself. So don't abandon yourself and start looking for things. Find yourself, and every other thing you are looking for in life will come to you the same way. Finding yourself is finding the kingdom. Let me make you to think. Let me say again, I said that finding yourself is finding the kingdom. And looking for yourself is looking for the kingdom. Because there can't be any kingdom outside you. And that's why Jesus Christ, when the disciples of Jesus were busy asking Jesus, I said, is it this time that the God will give hand over the kingdom back to the Jews? Jesus told them, I said, that the kingdom does not come by observation, not by lofting around our thoughts. He said, because the kingdom is already within you. So, a lot of people, when they hear about God's kingdom, they will start gazing into the geographical heaven. And as long as they continue to gaze in the geographical heaven, in the name of looking for God's kingdom, they will be lost. They can never be part of that kingdom. So he said, blessed assurance. I want to read a great encounter in the book of John 1. Said, and there was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. The same came to Jesus by night to say to him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher, come from God, for no man can do these miracles that thou dost, except God be with him. Jesus answered and said unto him, verily, verily, I said unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus said unto him, how can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born? And Jesus answered, verily, verily, I said unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. That which is born of flesh is flesh, and that which is born of spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I said unto thee, ye must be born again. 8, where we stop, the wind bloweth where it listeth, and thou hearest the sound thereof, but canst not tell hence it goeth, and whither where it cometh, and whither it goeth. So is everyone that is born of the Spirit. Now you've heard me said earlier on that you are a mystery. You are a complicated being. And now hear me. One of the ways to know that you are treading on a path of death is to live a life that everybody can understand. If everybody can interpret you and predict you, then you're already on the path to death. You are not meant to live that way. Because every man that is living is a mystery. Now, you are a mystery, not only to yourself, but you are a mystery to spirits. How do I know? If you go to the book of Psalm 8, now you will see it. But I will not go into that. Maybe in the third series, I will be going into some other things because I want to stop. So I'm here to encourage you to start paying attention. Like I have said, when you hear me talk about seeking yourself, I'm talking about looking. And I'm talking about meditation. They are synonymous. And just like there's a principle that governs seeking. If you don't seek, you can't find. And if you don't look, you can't see. So it is looking that commands seeing. So for a man to see, then he must look first. And that's the power of looking. Because it is looking that commands seeing. So there can't be seeing without looking. And before a man can see clearly, he needs to stand on a platform. So it is where you start to look that will control how you, what you will see and how clear what you are seeing will appear to you. So for you to see yourself clearly, you need to stand on the platform of the personal revelation that you have depended on fellowshipping with God's word to know. What I'm doing is just to introduce you to a path. Now, the rest work is left in your hand. Now, because there is no man on earth can be what he didn't make effort to look for or to become. So you can only become what you devote time to look for. You can only know yourself when you devote time to look for yourself. You can only see yourself if you start paying attention, if you start asking yourself questions, because yourself is hidden inside of you. By the grace of God, when I will be teaching on the revelation that I just caught today, that thought is an expensive thing. Yeah, there are things I'll be revealing that teaching. So I want to stop so far. And I believe that you are blessed. And I want to encourage you, as soon as this message gets to you, try to subscribe to our YouTube channel to encourage us, because by God's grace, we are looking forward to be running live services every day, because we know that this season is looking for light. And by the grace of God, election of grace has positioned us to be a voice that will bring lasting solution to our generation. God bless you, Emperor Emmanuel Melchizedek, voice of everlasting solution, the word of unique relevance, Christian fellowship, non-denominational teaching minister. Have 3-in-1 manifold mandate. And the first one is to bring unity among different religious bodies. The second one is to bring lasting solution to the capital problem of man and his environment. And the third is to unite nations, different nations of the world. Yeah, to bring them in oneness through revealed word of God. God bless you as you tune in the same time, the same channel, the same station. And make out time to watch other messages that has been lined up because of you in this very platform and channel. God bless you till I see you next week.